You are not to go to that woman's villa.
Mother, I will visit Lady Featherstone as often as I wish.
Can't you realize she's ruining you? She's left her husband, the Earl of Featherstone. She has forfeited any position she may have in society.
Oh, I think not. You forget what a powerful name we bear. Were I to make Lady Featherstone my wife, she would be accepted by my friends.
A wife? You're surely not thinking of marrying her? Oh, don't you see? That would mean a divorce from her husband. A divorce, Robert. Have you thought of that?
I have.
Oh, you have always been willful. Lady Featherstone has a bad reputation. Be sure of this. I will never accept her.
So be it. You know, you really should not be out alone at this time in the morning. Gambling breeds desperate men.
I know, I'm sorry. I just wanted to see the sunrise from here. Did you know Sandivorte landed here? Her chapel's down there. It was in 300 AD. There was a painting of it in the convent. That's why I wanted to see the sunrise. Lovely. Beyond words.
Lovely beyond words. Tell me, what is your name?
Mistral.
And your other name?
Oh, you mustn't ask me that. My aunt would be furious if she knew I was out here. I only left the convent a week ago.
The convent? How long had you been there?
Since I was six.
Six? And now? Your home. Do you live here now, Monte Carlo?
Monsieur, you ask too many questions.
You are quite right. My apologies. Allow me to introduce myself. Lord Stanford. Robert Stanford.
Oh, I really must be going.
I shall see you again.
Oh, Lord Stanford, I don't expect so.